YouTube, and in today's video I wanted to talk a bit about mental health. I don't have to give my standard nicotine disclaimer because I'm not going to be discussing anything related to vaping in this video. I wanted to talk about anxiety and depression because those are two things I suffer from and I still struggle with them today. I was diagnosed with anxiety and depression quite a few years ago now. So if you are suffering from either anxiety or depression or maybe both, my heart goes out to you because I know what that's like. It's not easy. I have been prescribed two things for anxiety. I have been prescribed a beta blocker called propranolol. Now you might be wondering why I would be prescribed a beta blocker, which is normally for blood pressure and heart conditions, that kind of thing. Why I would be prescribed that for anxiety? And the reason is it actually does help with anxiety. A lot of the time when people have panic attacks, they're given propranolol, and it works because it helps with the physical side effects of anxiety because it blocks adrenaline, which reduces your anxiety. So that's why it's used as a normal first-line treatment. Therapy doesn't work. The second thing I can prescribe is a benzodiazepine. I'm not going to say which one because it's not really relevant, since they really do the same thing. It's not Xanax. Xanax is not prescribed by the NHS. Also known as alprazolam. Alprazolam is the generic name for Xanax. Xanax is the brand name. It's not prescribed by the NHS, so you can't really get it in the UK. I think you can on a private prescription, but that is very, very expensive, and most people can't afford that. Most people rely on the NHS, and the NHS doesn't give that out. So if you're struggling with anxiety, a few tips. It can help to talk to a friend or family member or boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife, etc. Maybe they can help give you some support if you need it. You can try watching Chill Out, Calm Down videos on YouTube. There are lots of good channels that do that kind of content. Those are some options. If you are still struggling and nothing seems to work, maybe try going to a doctor and then maybe refer you to therapy to start with. That's what they did for me. They referred me to counselling and CBT, cognitive behavioural therapy. If that doesn't work, they may go down the road of medication. Much as beta blockers, all of those don't help, and benzodiazepines. But if they do prescribe a benzodiazepine, it is very, very important that you do not drink alcohol with them because the two clash really badly, and you also can't take opiate-based painkillers or anything else that could make you drowsy, such as sleeping pills, etc. Anything that can make you drowsy can't be taken with a benzodiazepine because the two can enhance each other, which is really dangerous and could lead to being seriously hurt or ending up in hospital or in extreme cases even death. And I'm not saying that sounds scary, there have been stories in the news of that happening. And it is also very important if you are prescribed benzodiazepines that you take them exactly how your doctor tells you to, and you don't take more than you're supposed to. You don't take them more often or in higher doses because they are addictive and they can have very nasty withdrawal symptoms that can be quite dangerous, and you can have seizures and stuff. So it is very, very, very important that you follow your doctor's instructions exactly and you don't take more than you should. I only take the benzodiazepine when I absolutely have to. That's why I prepare it all first. That's why I count down the days. That's why I talk to people. That's why everything else first before I resort to going to dive with things. Things like dive things are my last resort for me. They are the last thing I try. I try everything else first before I resort to those. Because I don't want to have to deal with benzodiazepine withdrawal. It is a nightmare. I have seen it happen to other people, and I do not want that to happen to me. It's not nice. So benzodiazepines aren't normally given out by doctors unless they think it's absolutely necessary and for a very good reason, because of the addiction and withdrawal. That's what I wanted to say about anxiety. Now for depression, I have been prescribed antidepressants. They have tried me on several different antidepressants because it took several different ones before they found one that actually worked. I've tried sertraline, which didn't agree with me at all, and I'm very sick. The one I'm currently on now, which is really good, is called mitazapine. It is like less pain than one. Mitazapine is like an SSRI in the sense that it has to be taken for 4 weeks before it starts to work. All antidepressants are like that, unfortunately. There's no such thing as an antidepressant that works as soon as you start taking it. It would be great if there was, but no one's invented anything like that. So people who think antidepressants don't work usually haven't been given the right one, or they haven't taken their medication long enough for it to work. They've tried it for maybe a couple of days and then it hasn't worked, so they've given up on it and decided they don't work. Or they've been prescribed the wrong one, because an antidepressant only works if it's the right one, because some people respond to some but not others. That's why there's more than one type of antidepressant. Well, there's many different SSRIs, many different MAOIs, which is another type of antidepressant, many things that are similar to mitazapine, and many other antidepressants, there's literally hundreds. So it can take a while before we find the correct one. I had to try several before I found one that worked. And the one that worked for me is mitazapine, which is a once a day nighttime medication, and it does work. It took about 3 to 4 weeks before I noticed my mood was better and I felt less depressed. So that has been my video on mental health and anxiety and depression. And that's a bit different than my usual vape content, but I thought it was important to talk about because not many people talk about mental health. It's not talked about very often because people with mental health are seen as, we have this culture where you're seen as weak or that something's wrong with you or you should be ashamed of it if you have mental health problems in your medication, but it is nothing to be ashamed of at all. When you had a broken arm and you had to take medication, you had to take pain medication because you broke your arm, would you be ashamed of that? Or no, you wouldn't. It's the same with antidepressants. If you have depression because you've got a chemical imbalance in your brain that causes you to have depression, that's not anything to be ashamed of. But that has been my video on mental health. I hope you enjoyed this video. I've been Making Vapes. If you did enjoy this video, maybe give it a like. If you really liked it, maybe subscribe. Hit the notification bell, because I do make vape content quite often. Although this wasn't a vape video, but my usual content is vape content. So if that's something you're interested in, then you might want to subscribe for more vape content. Until next time, I'll see you again soon, and have a good one.